Welcome back to Science Hub. I'll be Patience Mogori.
Gizma Steven.
Thanks, welcome.
For now, we'll be discussing about external features in plants and animals. External features in plants, there are rhizomes in most plants, fronds in ferns, and root stems, flowers, seeds in corn and cones. In external features in animals, there are tentacles in hydra. An example of tentacle would be having. These are the tentacles in hydra. Feathers in birds. Feathers in birds. Shells in animals. Wings in birds. Fur in mammals. And mammary glands in mammals. Locomotion of structure. Locomotion in this place means movement of animals from one place to another. In scales in fish, we have a sample. Here are the scales in fish. Wow. And my friend will be taking you to the next topic.
Now we have the new classification. Just tell them about classification. I'm not talking about classification.
We've talked.
Classification, it is a bit area of priority that deals with the grouping and placing animals in their similarity structures. This, we have need of studying classification to help in identifying grouping things and present into the correct groups. E.g., we have groups of mammals, groups of amphibians, that is a need of classification to help us to know this animal is a mammal or it is an amphibian. We also got another important grouping together of living similarities. It helps us to put according to their characteristics, similar characteristics. E.g., there is mammal who give birth and there is those who lay eggs. And then we have another need. It helps us to arrange information according to the living organism in order. So it also helps us to evaluate the relationship between different organisms. We also have taxonomic unit of classification. In this taxonomic, it refers to groups or taxa. We have 7 major units. My friend will explain them to you.
We have taxonomic units. Taxonomic units. There, kingdom, division, or phylum. Class, order, family, genus, and species. In order to remember all of this, we can use this formula of king, which goes with kingdom, King David, which goes with division or phylum, could, which goes with class, could only, it simply goes with order, fine, family, green, and green socks. In order to remember this, you can also simply use this formula of King David could only find himself. My friend will explain the next part.
As you were told by my fellow here, that taxonomy unit, there are 7 of them. As she said, when you want to remember all this, you use King David could only find green socks. Green socks. Living organisms are grouped into five kingdoms, e.g., example, king, Kingdom Monera. Kingdom Monera, e.g., bacteria. Bacteria affect, the sample of bacteria were being brought by flight. They affect human. Kingdom Protista, e.g., algae. And then there's kingdom fungi. Example, molds and yeast. Then there's kingdom, the fourth one, there's kingdom plantae, e.g., molds and plant. Then the fifth one, there's kingdom animalia. Example, hydra, tapeworm, bee and human beings and ECT. The kingdom is the largest taxonomy group into seven phyla or division in plant. The phyla is divided into group called classes. My friend will teach you.
Hi. As you have been taught, you will see the taxonomic units. We also have got orders which are divided into families. Families, in general, are called genus. In genus, structure of feathers are not easily noticed because their grouping is based on fairing. Descent, common essential that are raised up natures. In another way, we have scientific naming of living organisms. This scientific naming organism was introduced by Carlos Linnaeus in 18th century. Living organism has their naming structure, e.g. Rocaventura. This name cannot be used by science because they cannot be used in their local languages because each local language have got their own names. So they are linked with a Latin known all over the world. We have got local binomial nomenclature. This is where we refer to the scientific name of organism, which is also called double naming of organism. E.g., we have got many. We have got maize. It can't be like that because some they don't understand. So we have to say Z maize. And you are the right picture like that. Separately, my friends will give the rules of binomial nomenclature.
These rules and principle of binomial nomenclatures, it requires that this first name of these scientific names should start with a capital letter, e.g., let's use Anthereleo. This first name should start with a capital letter, Anthera. Anthereleo. Yeah. And also the second name should start with the capital letter of this. The first name should also start with the capital letter and the second name. The scientific name should be printed in italics. When handwritten in books, they should be underlined separated. Like my friend Nancy has shown you, they should be separated, Z means. The specific name infrequently written with names of the scientific who first adequately describe the name, the organism. Yeah, a common binoceras that was first described by scientists was known as Linnaeus. Biologists must give a Latinized name for a nearly described plant species where Latin name is missing. Yeah, for example, we come up with a new species that the biologists have discovered. They should give a Latinized name for that species, for a newly species.
Yeah.
And examples of scientific names are like maize, zimaize, beans, potatoes, Solomon tuberosum, green maize, Passum sativum, black jack and Bidens pilosa. Yeah.
With that, we come to the end of our discussion. I have been Nicole Sangani,
Christmas Diva,
and Patience Muguri.
Keep it a real TV where we
watch and learn.